Good evening to everybody. I want to sincerely give my appreciation to the staff and faculty of the University of Bath, not only for this honor today, but for all of the support as I received as a student 20 years ago. As you well know, this is a very special place, a place where knowledge is shared, dreams are nourished, and individuals are supported in becoming the best versions of themselves. I want to thank my family that cannot be here, except for my mom in the front row there, Dr. Charlotte Lamp. Thank you for always showing up for me. Although she's a little bit jealous that I'm getting this honorary degree, she did her degree the proper way, earning her PhD at the age of 67. And to all of the moms and dads, aunts and uncles, grandmothers, grandfathers, step-parents, foster parents, fill-in parents, pseudo-parents, neighbors, friends, mentors, and other supporters of the graduates, today is your day also. Thank you very much. I remember my days as a student here very fondly. I was so full of ambition and optimism for the future, much like you are, and not necessarily to become an astronaut, because who really gets to do that? But I was getting my degree at an early age and heading off to flight school. And today I'm very proud to be part of NASA. Much like the University of Bath, it is an ambitious organization. In the 1960s, during the Apollo program, the United States was in a space race driven by competitive ambition, a race to see who could put boots on the moon first and return safely to Earth. The key was to get there safely, but to do it quickly. Decisions were made during the design processes that reflected this urgency. As soon as a piece of equipment was deemed good enough, it was accepted and we moved to the next task. Factors of safety and redundancy were sacrificed in the interest of schedule. Today's ambition is different. Our focus is again on deep space exploration, going back to the moon under the Artemis program. But the Artemis program itself is fundamentally different. We are still in a space race, but not for boots on the moon. We are in a space race for norms. The next group on the moon will establish the international norms by which all countries will explore space. We believe space exploration must be conducted responsibly for the good of all mankind. And we believe space exploration is for everybody. The Artemis Accords, which were established in 2020, are a set of written norms by which we seek to explore space. They've been signed by many of our partner countries, many of the countries that you all are from. The United Kingdom, Brazil, France, Korea, Poland, Saudi Arabia. These accords establish the basic principles for cooperation in space. All space exploration must be done for peaceful purposes. It must be conducted transparently to minimize the possibility of misperceptions of intentions. We must share all scientific data discovered off of our planet for the betterment of all humankind. And importantly, we must protect space resources and environments in a sustainable manner. How we explore space is just as important as what we do. Graduates, how does this impact you? Your graduation today is a product of your own ambition. And I want you to think back to the goal that you set 3, 4, 5, 6 years ago when you decided that you wanted to be sitting here today. Think about the decisions you made to get from there to here and the effort that you put in. I want you to reflect on why you chose to do that. Did you want to be able to make a bigger impact in the world? Did you want to qualify for a different type of job? Did you seek knowledge beyond that which you possessed? I would offer you that the pride that you and your families feel today is as much about your reasons why as it is about the actual achievement. And my challenge to you going forward is to be a little bit more like the Artemis program. Stay ambitious while remembering your why. What do you want your legacy to be? What impact do you want to have on the people around you? What are your core values and how will you live them out? Who do you want by your side? How will you use your influence once you have it? And perhaps most importantly, don't forget to live your life while you plan this future. It will be behind you before you know it, and that journey will have been your life. Make it a good one.